If any of you have read MCN lately or checked out any of our videos, you'll know that we're in love with the new 848 Evo, Ducati's supersport bike. But if you want a supersport bike, there are other choices. And you can have a Japanese 4 in the shape of this screaming R6, or a great British 3-cylinder in the shape of the Triumph Daytona 675. So which is the best? Well, let's find out.
Right, this is what's going to happen. We're going to ride these bikes on the road, which is pretty straightforward, but we're also going to take them around the track. We're at Siracusa Racetrack in Sicily, and it's a punishing track. Real test of bikes handling, stability, and top speed. What we're going to do, we're going to put control tyres on all three of the bikes, Pirelli Diablo Supercourses, and we're going to do a lap time, see which is fastest. We'll also be able to record its top speed, and also we're going to data log the bikes and get all the performance information. Then we're going to take them on the road, change the tyres, put Pirelli Diablo Rosso Corsa tyres on, so we create a level playing field and see which one's the best. Let's do some half-time scores. We've ridden all three of these bikes on the track, and they're all equipped with SC2 Supercorsa racing tyres. And we've actually got one of Pirelli's Italian Championship superbike riders to do our lap times for us. He knows the track better, so it's more consistent. The R6 posted a time of 154 and did a maximum speed on the clock of 257 k's. R6 is absolutely fantastic to ride. It screams. It's actually the comfiest and the roomiest of the bunch, but it feels a little bit old now. The quality of the suspension and the brakes isn't quite up there with the rest. Right, second place on the track, we've got the Daytona 675. It's got about the same power as the R6, 110 horsepower, but it was over a second quicker with a 153.78, and on the clock it did exactly the same top speed. Now this feels a bit nicer to ride than the R6 on the track. You don't have to be quite as critical with it, with gear changes and keeping it in the revs, because it's got more grunt. But it sounds fantastic and it's really exciting to ride. But Ducati 848 Evo is the fastest on the track by a long way. It is a 152.19, which is 2 seconds faster than the R6, second faster than the Daytona. Posted a top speed of 271 k, which is a fair amount faster down the straights as well. This bike feels like a pucker racing bike compared to the other two, and the Italian superbike rider who did our lap times for us said that this feels like a world super sport bike compared to these two road bikes, which is praise indeed. The brakes are fantastic with the 1198R calipers on board. There's power everywhere, it revs, it's got grunt, it's really agile, steers beautifully, it's very stable, but on the very fast corners there's a lot of weight on the rear, so you do get a lot of head shaking from the front. But we left the suspension set in standard, you can easily dial that out. So as far as the track side goes, the Ducati is the winner, but we're going to go out on the roads now to get an overall verdict. We've had a fair few hours in the saddle now since leaving the Siracusa racetrack, and we're halfway up Mount Etna. Now, the most surprising things with these bikes on the road, with the R6, is how comfortable it is. For the ride home, I'm going to be fighting for the keys for the R6 because it's very comfortable, the seat's soft, the power delivery is really gentle, and it's like a sleeping psycho. It's actually quite nice to live with until you poke it and then it goes absolutely mad. The Triumph is kind of a little bit more sporty, a little bit more aggressive, although the flexibility of the 3-cylinder engine I really, really like. And the Ducati, all 122 horsepower of it, it's like a race bike on the road. It just doesn't want to cruise. It just wants to go back to the racetrack. Right, so for me, the best bike here is the Ducati by country mile. Sets the fastest lap time, the best top speed, it's got the best brakes, it's got the best chassis, and it's so much fun. For 10.5 grand, it's a lot of bike for the money. It's got all the super sport character that you want. It's got a revvy engine, it's got a slim back tyre for super agility, but calling it a super sport bike might be stretching it a little, because at 848cc it's almost as big as the 851 superbike of the late 80s. But either way, it's a fantastic bike. Out of the other two true super sport bikes, the R6 is actually quite friendly but feels a bit dated, and for me I prefer the Daytona. Just a little bit more aggressive, bit more torque, sounds fantastic, but all three of these bikes are great.